गुड इवनिंग सर।
গুড ইভিনিং স্যার।
গুড ইভিনিং। কত দূর হয়েছিল আমাদের ডিজাইন লাস্ট ক্লাসে?
স্যার আপ টু উই হ্যাভ ফাউন্ড দ্য উইথ অ্যান্ড ডেপথ অফ দ্য স্লট।
ওকে, সো ইজ দ্যাট কমপ্লিট ফর অল?
স্যার 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 আমার তো লো ভোল্টেজ মেশিন আছে, তো স্লট ইনসুলেশন নিতে হবে 1 মিলিমিটার ওয়াইড।
হ্যাঁ, স্লট ইনসুলেশন 1 mm না হলেও 1 mm চেয়ে ছোট অল্প নিতে পারো। দেখতে হবে তার চেয়ে ছোট, তার চেয়ে পাতলা ইনসুলেশন ইজ অ্যাভেলেবল অর নট। ইউ ক্যান টেক 0.5 mm।
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে
স্যার। স্যার ইন দ্য লাস্ট ক্লাস আই থিঙ্ক ইউ হ্যাভ মেনশন টু টেক 0.25 ফর দ্য ইনসুলেশন অফ দ্য রেক্ট্যাঙ্গুলার বার।
দ্যাট ইজ আ ওয়্যার ইনসুলেশন।
Yes, sir.
That is a wear insulation.
Along with that, we have to take any extra insulation also, sir.
Slot insulation is a different thing, and the wear conductor insulation is different. Conductor will have its own insulation, and slot will have a separate insulation.
Sir, I have added only the wired insulation. হ্যালো স্যার।
বলো।
স্যার বলছি যে আমার 250 ভোল্ট মেশিন আছে, তো স্যার স্লট ইনসুলেশন 1 মিলিমিটার নিলে হবে? সো হবে স্যার। ঠিক আছে স্যার, থ্যাংক ইউ।
So these are the slot insulation, which is already there in the slot. Now these are the conductors. This is small machines, so they are used to round conductors. So this is the insulation. Okay, so they are using this as a wedge. These coils, these conductors are already insulated. because original copper doesn't have this color. This color that you can see here, that is the color of the insulation. Okay. Now have you checked the flux density at 1/3 height of the pit base? Have you checked the flux density? Oh, I am asking that, have you checked the flux density at 1/3 height of the base from the teeth? So that you can calculate. So that is called the PT 1/3. Flux density at 1/3 height of the teeth. That should not
sir actually sir I'm actually having some problems with the slot design sir
why
sir my sir actually my my cross section is not rectangular sir it's circular my diameter is coming out to be 2.02 millimeter and my SWG value is coming out as 14 sir but sir after that what to do sir I actually I don't know sir that's why
So I discussed that thing in details in the last class. So if you have not followed,
yes, sir.
Then
actually,
you just go through
you
the book. Now, yeah, what you have to do, you have to count how many, you have to see that how many conductors should be placed in the slot. Okay.
Sir,
and
my number of slots.
Estimate not number of slots. How many conductors should be placed in the slot? You are designing a slot. Conductor design already has been done. That is finalized. Now you
sir.
Have to design your slot. The slot should be designed. Okay. Now you have to place your conductor like this, your round conductor like this. Accordingly, you have to find out the height and the width. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So these are the teeth. Okay. And once you have found
yes.
out the slot dimension, you can find out the teeth dimension as well. Now, once the teeth dimension is finalized, then you have to calculate at this point what is the flux density. So, BT 1/3. So, this is the 1/3 height from the base.
Okay, sir. Sir, what is the sir the significance of SWG?
Significance means SWG means standard wear gauge table. That is the available dimension of the conductor. It's mentioned those in that table.
Yes, sir. Like my SWG value has come out to be 14, but DC equals to 2.02 millimeter. So, sir, what
is now you have to find out from the table what is the nearest value you are getting. You have to see from the SWG chart that what is the nearest value you are getting.
Yes, sir, I am getting 2.0320. So my actual value came out as 2.02, but from the chart it's coming out as 2.0320. That is my nearest.
And that should be with the considering the insulation.
Sir, my voltage is 440 volt. So my voltage is 440 whatever volt, voltage, so I have to consider
1 millimeter is not the conductor insulation. Conductor insulation is also there in the SWG charge XLY. If you have book at the end, you have the table.
Okay, sir.
Then it has the tables for SWG chart at the end of the book.
Okay, sir. I will have to see for that. Oh, and sir, one more thing, sir. That while the slot design, sir, you said that number of conductors per slot. So, sir, my number of conductors is 1050, and my number of slots is 36. So we have to divide 1050 by 36 in order to get the number of conductors per slot.
Conductor per slot, like that we have determined last to last class. Now you are asking that how the conductors per slot is calculated.
No, no, sir. I have actually calculated the number of conductors and also the number of slots as well. Like I'm just
the number of conductors already we have calculated conductor per slot.
Yes, sir.
That you that value only.
Yes, sir. Like my number of coil sites per slot, it is coming as 6.
How many coil conductors are there in a coil that you find out from there, and from that you have to find out what is the conductor per slot.
Okay, sir. So that much amount of conductors will be placed in one slot. So accordingly, I have to find out the height,
yes,
and the width.
According to find out the room for it.
Okay, sir. Understood. Thank you, sir.
You have to first you have to find out the dimension of that. Okay. Dimension means this the width of the suppose you have.
Yes, sir.
Right. So you have taken all parallel slots are parallel, isn't it? Then your tooth cannot be parallel because tooth should be tapered. Why? Because suppose this is the total dia. Okay. Correct. Now, if we subtract from this dia, if we subtract twice the height of the slot, you will get what you will get? You will get this dia. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if we subtract that into 2/3, which dia we should get? We should get the dia around 1/3 height. বুঝতে পারছো আমরা আট তো বেশি ডায়া পাবো মানে এইখানে ডায়াটা পাবো ওয়ান থার্ড হাইট হাইট বরাবর যে ডায়াটা সেটা পাবো গট ইট সো অ্যারাউন্ড দিস ওয়ান থার্ড হাইট ইফ উই ড্র আ সার্কেল ইট উইল গিভ দ্যাট ডায়া অনলি ওকে নাও ইফ that dia if you take and if you multiply with the pi what you will get bolo
ha bolo sir acha ha theek
that line at height 1/3 height okay at that you if you divided by number of slot if you divided by number of slot what you will get you will get the pitch means between these two what is the length the pitch you will get right okay so that means if we take one slot one pitch so you will get the pitch means this is the pitch slot is not exactly slot pitch but pitch along the 1/3 height okay from that you have subtract this slot width then what you will get then you will get the tooth width along 1/3 height got it so if you subtract this then you will get that tooth width ki babe to
yes sir
and then to calculate the area you should have another dimension that is the length so this is basically a 3D thing okay now you have to take this length
sir you are not audible properly sir
yes
because
sir.
The flux is passing through this surface okay so you should multiply with this length so this is the area for calculating this BT 1/3 so this WT 1/3 into L okay LI বুঝতে পারছো কিভাবে এরিয়াটা ক্যালকুলেট করবে দিস এরিয়া অফ দ্য দেন ইউ হ্যাভ টু ডিভাইড ইট বাই দ্য ফ্লাক্স লেন No, the flux must be divided by this area. Then you will get the flux density. We have obtained the flux per pole. The flux per pole you have already obtained. The flux per pole you have to divide it by this value. Then you will get the BP 1/3.
Yes, sir.
পরিচয় কেন ক্যালকুলেশন
স্যার 2.68 এসছে
এখানে জাস্ট ডু ওয়ান থিং ইফ ইউ আর টেকিং ফ্লাক্স পার পোল দেন ইউ হ্যাভ টু টেক দ্য স্লট পার পোল অলসো So, slot per pole, how you can calculate number of slot divided by pole. So, this value you have to multiply here. Then the calculation will be okay. I think it will be less than 2.1. If it is less than 2.1, then only it is okay. Otherwise, you have to revise the design.
স্যার আমার স্যার 1.333 আসছে স্যার
ওকে এনিথিং 2 পয়েন্ট লেস দ্যান 2.1 ইজ ওকে
ওকে স্যার
স্যার 0.814
ইজ ওকে
So 0.46.
Sir, I'm getting very low value of B. It's 14.5 milli.
Sorry? You just check your calculation.
Sir, 14.5 millitesla.
Yeah, mobile.
Don't be that. If your calculation.
Sir, 2.08.
Two point zero is a limiting one. Anyway, for small machine, it's okay. What is the size of the machine, rating of the machine?
Sir, 25 kilowatt.
Okay. But you just check your calculation.
Sir, I'm getting 1.666.
That's okay.
Sir, I am getting 2.2.
No, you have to recheck your calculation. It's still 2.2, then you have to change your design. I think your tooth become quite thin. Now you just tell me your width of the slot and width of the teeth.
Yes, sir. Width of the slot 15 millimeter.
50?
No, 15.
Okay. And?
And
width of the teeth?
Width of the teeth is equal to 5.96 millimeter.
No, that is wrong. Your design is wrong. Okay, so these two should be close.
Okay, okay.
If one is 15, another maybe 10 or 12 like that. It's not be 5. Okay, so what you have to change? I think you have taken like this.
Sir,
so you have to increase the depth instead of increasing in width. Suppose you have taken this is 15. And suppose you have taken this is 10. Okay.
Sir,
you have to take now this is 15 and this is 10. Then it can be managed.
Sir, my CPS is 8, conductor part slot. And my AC is 18.2 millimeter square. So I took 3 into 6 the conductor, 3 into 6 millimeter square, so 3.5 into 6.5. 6.5
you have to place like this in vertically. Right.
Yes, sir. So my WA should be 3.5 into 4 plus. One.
No, then you have to change the other aspect ratio you have to take. If 3.5 is giving 15, then you have to try for 2.5. You see,
no, 2. Sir, 5 I just
into, suppose 8 or so.
Okay, sir. Now, I want to check my method is correct or not. Just sir, WS. Then if I take 3.5, so 3.5 into 4 plus 1, is it correct?
That is after drawing the slot, you can understand calculating the geometry from the geometry. First, you draw the slot, how you are arranging your conductors there.
Sir, you're in the right corner, your bottom right corner, you draw that just like that. I have made it.
So, that only you have to draw and you have to calculate what are the slot insulation, what are the conductor insulation. Conductor will have both side insulations, slot will have both side insulation. Accordingly, you have to calculate. There should be some spacer in the height, there should be some spacer, insulation, wedge, etc. Leaf. So all these we have to take into account. Accordingly, you have to calculate the height and width.
Okay.
So one sample calculation is given in the book, you just consult that.
Okay, sir.
Sir. Sir, our WT value wrong. Negative.
That means your design is wrong. The width
sir,
of the sir, slot is
with slot width 5.7.
Slot, if the slot pitch, if your width of the slot is more than slot pitch, then that can happen. So you change your width of the slot, you change your slot design. Your slot design should be vertical, not like this.
Sir,
use sir, only one device.
Sir, when I have designed the slot, then I was getting the width as 9 mm. But after calculating for the teeth, it is coming 14.5. So this much of variation is can be accepted.
No, what is the DT 1/3 you are getting? That is the checkpoint.
BT 1/3 I am getting 0.9 millitesla. I don't know. We have to keep it.
Somewhere you have done some error. Either calculating the flux per pole or slot per pole or this area. Somewhere you have done some error.
Sir, flux per pole we have already calculated. It was coming as, in my case, it was 32 milliweber.
32 milliweber, okay.
Yes. And the slot was 42. So 42 by 6. Number of pole was 6.
Mm-hmm.
Area is coming greater. Means it's like, sir, 4717.36 mm square.
Mm square, kokhono hoy? These are all in millimeter. You are calculating in millimeter. Slots, you are calculating, sir. All the dimensions are in millimeter. So yes, when we'll calculate the area, that will be millimeter square. So by default, you will get some 10 to the power minus 6. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then we check the calculation,
sir. Sir, bujhte pachhi na ki kore korbo.
Sir, we have to take the flux density in SI unit. Means flux density should be less than 2 tesla, right?
2.1.
Okay, sir.
Parashar, height the width for the SC slotted?
Slotted height, sir. Slot width 5.7 millimeter and slot depth 10.2 millimeter.
10.2?
Yes, okay, sir.
And what is the slot pitch?
Slot pitch. Slot pitch to. Sir, negative hai ache.
Slot pitch kokhono negative hoy. You just calculate a simple calculation. You just do pi d by s. What is the value you are getting?
Point 0.22. Sir, 0.22.
0.22 key, what is the unit?
Millimeter.
What is the unit?
Millimeter.
0.2 millimeter.
Sir, after 2 in, rather than 3 into 6, I just make 2 into 9 and my, it is coming 1.41. So is it okay? B is coming. 1.41.
It's okay.
So sir, after,
I asked to change. Is the aspect issue. Acha Parash, what is your D value?
1.85 millimeter.
Are D value kokhono millimeter hoy? D means the diameter of the armature, diameter of the air gap. So D must be in meter, some hundreds of millimeter.
Oh, acha.
D can be millimeter.
200.44
millimeter. 0.5. You have to take as a round figure. Anyway, so you have to calculate your slot pitch by this formula. Which D are you are using? So D is the main dimension that you have calculated at the beginning itself.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. I made a mistake. Sorry,
sir. After taking into the SI units, I am getting the flux density as 0.97. So I think
it's okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, my flux density is coming as 0.55.
point
55 0.55.
Is it less than the value you have taken for the air gap?
Yes, sir.
How it is possible? Should be more than the air gap at least. The air gap flux, how much you have taken at the beginning? These values should be more than that only.
So my flux per pole is 26.53 milliweber.
Anyway, you just recheck the calculation. Otherwise, it's okay as it is less than 2.1, but it is quite low. Even lower than the air gap flux density.
Okay, sir. I'm going to check.
The next thing you calculate the armature AT, armature ampere turn. How to calculate armature ampere turn? That is the number of, okay, so the first ampere or the current in the parallel path that you have taken. I don't know what is the value, what is thing I have used, what is the notation I have used. So armature current per parallel path into the total number of conductor divided by the number of poles. Okay. So into 2.
Sir, flux density 1.245 change করা পর configuration. কিন্তু sir configuration টা valid কিনা বুঝতে পারছি না মানে মানে 16 খানা conductor আমাকে মানে একটা কলমে রাখতে হচ্ছে আর কি. ঠিক আছে.
Conductor per slot কত?
Actually 12 ছিল but এক একটাকে 4 4 parallel conductor bhante so for ki
eta kora jete pare
tar ebong ek ekta ke ekta column e 16 khana rakhte hobe ar tinte row sorry 16 ta row ar tinte column
tinte 16 ki row column bhurte bhurte achhe
vertically
16 tinte column kokhono hoy na but vertically there should be only 2 so there can be only 2 rows. Column may be multiple, not more than 10, but it can be more, but the row should be 2 because it's a double layer winding.
Ekta layer e ki ektai conductor hote pare shei khetre
na ekta layer e to onek gulo conductor hote pare.
I am wrong here na.
So I have drawn four conductor in each layer. So this is one layer. So this is one layer. So this is another layer. In each layer we have 4 conductors. That is possible. 4, 6, 8 up to 10 conductor is possible. And each conductor also may have multiple parallel conductor. That is possible. But maximum 2 layer is possible.
Sir, a word. I mean, ekta conductor ke jodi চারটে প্যারালালে কনভার্ট করা হয় সেই ক্ষেত্রে
হ্যাঁ সেটা যেটা আমরা ঘুরে রাখতে পারো সেটা তুমি কিভাবে অ্যারেঞ্জ করবে তোমার ওয়াইন্ডারকে যেভাবে তুমি বোঝাবে তুমি যদি এইভাবে করতে চাও করতে পারো, যদি এইভাবে চারটে কে অ্যারেঞ্জ করতে চাও সেটাও করতে পারো।
ভার্টিক্যালি
চারটে, ভার্টিক্যালি চারটে, মানে তুমি বলতে চাইছো যে এইরকম ভাবে, এইরকম ভাবে জিনিসটাকে মানে করাটা তো ডিফিকাল্ট, দুটো করে করা যায়।
স্যার না হলে উইথ বহুত বেড়ে যাচ্ছে আসলে, মানে ডেপথ বাড়ানো যাচ্ছে না।
হ্যাঁ তুমি কন্ডাক্টরের ডাইমেনশনটা, ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল কন্ডাক্টরের ডাইমেনশন চেঞ্জ করছো না।
ওকে
স্যার, এখানে আইটা আর্মেচার কারেন্ট ইন ইচ প্যারালেল পাথ অর টোটাল আর্মেচার কারেন্ট?
আর্মেচার কারেন্ট ইন ইচ প্যারালেল পাথ।
ওকে স্যার, ওকে স্যার।
আর্মেচার অ্যাম্পিয়ার টার্নস স্যার 3119 আসছে।
স্যার ইন মাই কেস ইট ইজ কামিং অ্যারাউন্ড 3133.3। স্যার আমার অ্যাম্পিয়ার টার্নস আসছে 4491।
স্যার আমার আছে 2623।
স্যার আই এম গেটিং 2093।
দেন ইউ ক্যালকুলেট দ্য এয়ার গ্যাপ এটি, which should be 60% of that gap. The air gap AT will be 60% of the armature area.
So my ampere turns 1737 as. Sir, ampere turn
Just a minute. Hello. So when you are calculating the armature ampere turn, you have to calculate the, you have to take the total number of armature conductor. That is ZA. And the armature current per parallel path.
So taking the 60% for the air gap armature turn, it is coming around 1879.98. Hello?
Hello.
Yes, sir. For the air gap, it is coming around 1879.98. 60%. It is 60%.
Yes, okay.
Yes,
so what is the size of this machine? What is the rating? It's okay. Sir, 60% thing, that is for the air gap.
The air gap armature turns is coming as 1871.35.
What is the size of your machine that I'm asking?
Sir, for in my case the size was 110 kilowatt.
Sir, mine was
110 kilowatt. 220
yes,
kilowatt.
Yes, sir.
So
110 is quite low. If it is 200 kilowatt, then what is...
Sir, 110 kilowatt.
110 kilowatt.
Yes, sir.
Then what is the number of conductor? Is it low?
Sir, conductor was 328.
Huh? And what is the current?
Sir, current in each parallel path.
What have you taken? It's a lap or wave?
Sir, lap. 114.63 ampere.
If you are taking lap, then the armature ampere turns will be low. If you are taking wave,
yes, sir.
Then the ampere turns will be high.
Sir, then taking the lap winding, it is coming air gap. For the air gap, it is coming 1879.98 ampere turn.
Okay.
Sir, my flux density is coming at 0.873.
Okay.
Sir, for 35 kilowatt machine. Hello? I'm getting the ampere turn equal to 2283. Yes, sir. Is it okay?
Sir, our 120 kilowatt machine, sir, air gap 80 has 2694.70.
Air gap?
Air gap ampere turns, 2694.70.
What type of winding you have taken?
Sir, lap winding.
All you are taking lap winding.
Yes, sir. Okay. Okay, sir.
Wave. Wave, the current rating always will be high. Flux density.
Sir, for 220 kilowatt machine and lap winding, I'm getting the armature ampere turns as ampere turns, and the air gap one is 1871.
So for 5 kilowatt machine, I'm getting the air gap ampere turn as 798.486. So is the value okay?
For?
So for 5 kilowatt machine. Sir, my ampere turn for the air gap is coming as 798.486.
Your machine is small. Okay, so I think 80 G you have calculated. Then you calculate the air gap flux density, that you can calculate by average flux, modified average flux density that you have calculated already, divided by psi. Psi is the form factor, that is 0.67.
Sir? So the rating of my machine is 30 kilowatt and I am getting air gap ampere turn 652. Is it right?
Hello, you have to check. Once again, we'll just check.
Sir, my ampere turn is 1545.5. Sir, my ampere turn is equal to 1545.5.
Okay, so after calculating this BG, we have to calculate then a gap contraction factor. Gap contraction factor KG.
Sir, rating of machine is 30 kilowatt and I am getting air gap ampere turn 652.
What type of winding you have taken?
Lap on is
okay. Gap contraction factor you can take 1.15.
And sir, for the earlier one, BG, we have taken B average by psi.
Psi is the form factor. Psi means the pole arc by pole pitch. Okay. So this is the pole pitch and this is the pole arc.
Thank you.
Sir, length of air gap is coming as 2.5 millimeter. So then I will keep
it the size as of the machine.
The size of the machine was 110 kilowatt.
Okay, you take 4 millimeter.
Sir, but according to this empirical formula, I am getting 2.5.
Empirical formula, what?
Sir, this one. Cannot length of air gap. 2.5.
You cannot manage that 2.5 because it's a large machine. You cannot manage with this 2.5 mm gap.
Sir, I am getting 1.7 millimeter and the rating of my machine is 40 kilowatts.
Sir, sir, my length of the air gap is coming.
2 mm.
Sir, my length of the air gap is coming 2.34 millimeter.
Okay, 3 mm you take.
Okay.
Sir, my is coming 2.58 mm. So should I take 3?
This is cost.
Sir, for 35 kilowatt machine, I'm getting 2.22 millimeter.
What is the size?
35 kilowatt.
3 mm take.
Okay.
Sir, for 220 kilowatt machine, I'm getting the length of air gap is 2.2 millimeter.
You take 5 mm.
Okay, sir.
Sir, for 30 kilowatt machine, sir, my length of air gap is coming 2.776 millimeter.
You take 3.
Okay, sir.
One more time.
Sir, for 50 kilowatt, I am getting 2.58 mm. So, should I take 3 or 4?
What is the size? One second.
50 kilowatt, 50.
Okay, so you can take 3.
So for 160 kilowatt machine, I'm getting 1.58 length of air gap.
5.
Okay. Sir, our 120 kilowatt machine, sir, length of air gap is 3 millimeter.
You take 4. 4 mm.
Okay, sir, 4.
Sir, for 75 kilowatt machine, my LG is coming 2.02 millimeter.
2.02. Okay, you take 4 or 5. Okay, 4 you take, 4 mm.
Okay, for 75 kilowatt. Okay, sir, 4 mm.
Sir? Sir, I am getting length of air gap 1.05 mm. For rating 30 kV.
30 kilowatt.
Yes, yes, sir.
So you take 3 mm.
Okay.
Sir, for a 65 kilowatt rating, I'm getting 2.2 millimeter.
Okay, you take 4 or 5 mm.
Okay, okay, sir.
Sir, for 5 kilowatt machine, I'm getting 1.45. So, should I take 2?
You take 2. Okay, sir. 2 mm, less than 2 mm, it is not possible to maintain for any size of the machine.
Sir, for 40 kilowatt, I was getting 1.7. So, what should I take?
You take three or four.
Okay, sir.
So this is the calculation that is given in the book, but there is a some minimum value of length of air gap that depends on the manufacturing process by which you can maintain that. Because if the air gap is length of the air gap is quite low, it is difficult to maintain all throughout the length of the machine. Due to slight eccentricity, slight imbalance, it can create some problem, mechanical problem. So better to use length of the air gap more than 2 mm. And for large machine, which has very heavy weight, weight is more. In that case, at least 5 or 6 mm, more than 100 kilowatt machine, they should take either 5 mm or 6 mm. Those who have more than 60 kilowatt, they must have, they should take either 4 or 5 mm. Okay, so in this way you can take. Okay, so the armature core design, for that you have to take what is the value of armature core, armature flux. Armature flux, you will get the flux per pole that you have taken divided by 2, because it will be bifurcated. Once it will enter into the armature, it will be bifurcated. There will be 2 paths, so therefore it is 5/2. Okay, so that is the armature flux. Okay. Got it. And if you take a flux density of 1.2 Weber per meter square, then you can calculate the area of the armature core. That is phi A divided by armature flux density. Okay, now the depth of the armature you can calculate by dividing the length, this area dividing by the length. This way the armature core can be finalized.
Sir, how did we get the BA?
The main thing is BA, you have to assume comfortable value. Generally, we assume 1.2 Weber per meter square.
Okay.
For our major flux density. So flux density everywhere, we have to assume. Nobody will tell us what will be the armature, what will be the flux density at which position, which portion of the machine. So everywhere we have to assume the flux density and the current density. So that is the design. Generally, we take 1.2 Weber per meter square for armature core. Rohit, have you taken the attendance?
Sir, our DC has just 55.8196 millimeter.
Yes.
Sir, our DC has 25.75 for 35 kilowatt.
Okay. Have you understood what is DC? DC is basically this inner dia of this.
Okay, yes, sir.
So that is your DC.
Sir, for my case, it is coming as 41.2 mm.
Not exactly, not that is DC, that is up to the, okay, so up to this value. Not the diameter, it's a small DC, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, small DC, sir.
It's the depth of the cone, that means only this much.
Okay, sir.
So only this much. Now, to calculate the shaft diameter or the inner diameter of the armature lamination, how to calculate? Because this, what is this? This is your DS. Okay, so that means this D minus or you can just take D by 2 minus DS plus DC. Okay, so that will give you the radius. Okay, and if you want to calculate the dia, so that means this inner dia, that is DI, that will be twice of this, isn't it? That is the inner diameter of the armature lamination, capital DI. So this is how we are first calculating the radius. Okay, so this is your actually D by 2. So D by 2 minus DS minus DC is giving you the inner radius of the armature lamination. That into 2 will be the inner diameter of the armature lamination. Have you understood? So all these value you have, this you are getting from the main dimension. This is the slot depth. This is the code depth. Just now we have calculated. By using all this value, you can get the inner diameter of the armature lamination. for armature, these two are the important thing. One is the D, another is the DI. So these two will decide the lamination size, D and DI. D is the outer dia and DI is the inner dia of the armature lamination. And the number of lamination you have to calculate from the length of the armature and the thickness of the lamination, each lamination. Number of lamination you can calculate. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then you just calculate up to this before coming into the next class, the inner diameter of the armature core. The next class will start the designing of field system. Design of field system will start in the next class.
Sir, for the
okay, sir.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, diameter is coming as 218.9 mm for the inner one.
And what is your outer dia?
343.30, sir. That bigger D.
Okay. Okay.
Sir.
Okay.
Sir, outer diameter was 373 millimeter and inner diameter is
250.88
millimeter.
Okay.
Sir, my inner diameter is 283.76.
So my inner diameter is 242.14 and outer diameter is 315.
Okay, so if suppose if your inner diameter is not matched with the shaft, because shaft will have its own diameter and that is fixed from beforehand. So then what you have to do, you have to use some fill up with some solid iron. This inner diameter that you have just calculated, that is the inner diameter of the lamination. So that means up to this you have to use the lamination. Okay, after that you can use the solid iron, cast iron, cast steel, and then the shaft. Okay, so this is as per the design. And if you want, you can extend the lamination further. That means instead of having 250 inner diameter, you can use 200 also. Okay, suppose your shaft diameter is 150, then you can extend up to 150, or you can use 250 itself and 100 this wire here 50 mm ring you can use on the shaft as a fill up. Okay. So anyway, so I will end the class here. Before coming to the next class, all you have to complete up to this inner diameter of the armature core.